My dear student, come to the second concept. Okay, for exercise 5.2, second concept is of midpoint formula. Now you can see P is the midpoint of AB. So coordinate of P will be x comma y. Coordinate of A will be x1, y1. And coordinate of D is x2, y2. Okay. Now to find the value of x, to find the coordinate of x, your formula is x is equal to x1 plus x2 upon 2, and for y is equal to y1 plus y2 upon 2. Okay. To find out x, you will use this formula, x1 plus x2 upon 2. And to find out y, you will use this y is equal to y1 plus y2 upon 2. So this is called midpoint formula. Now your third concept is of centroid formula. You know, centroid comes in median. This is your median, first median, this is your second median, and this is your third median. When all three median intersect in a single point, that point is called centroid, and it is denoted by G. So coordinate of G will be x comma y. Coordinate of G will be x comma y. Coordinate of A will be x1 y1. Coordinate of B will be x2 y2. And coordinate of C will be x3, y3. Okay. Now to find out the value of x, you will use the formula. X is equal to x1 plus x2 plus x3 upon 3. And for y, you will write y is equal to y1 plus y2 plus y3 upon 3. Very easily. You will get the answer for x and y. So this is called your centroid formula. Okay. These are the three main basic concepts. These are the three main basic concepts related to practice set 5.2. Now come to the practice set 5.2. First sum. Find the coordinate of point P. So we will assume x comma y. Okay, which divides the line segment AB, okay, in ratio n is to n, that is 2 is to 3. Ratio is given to you, A coordinate is minus 1 comma 7, B coordinate is 4 comma minus 3. Okay, so here x1 is equal to minus 1, y1 is equal to 7. x2 is equal to 4, y2 is equal to minus 3, m ratio n is 2 is to 3. Okay, so m value will consider 2, n value will consider 3. Okay, is that clear? M value will consider 2, n value will consider 3. Now we want the value of x and y. So by using section formula. The formula is x is equal to mx2 plus nx1 upon m plus n. Okay. And y is equal to my2 plus ny1 upon m plus n. This two formula you will use. So x is equal to m. M is 2. 2 into x2 is 4. 2 into 4 plus n. N is 3. x1 is minus 1 upon m plus n. 2 plus 3. Okay. Here also same. Y is equal to m is 2. y2. y2 is minus 3 plus n is 3. y1 is 7 upon 2 plus 3. Same way. Therefore, x is equal to 4 2s are 8, 3 1s are 3, 3 into minus 1 will be minus 3 upon 5. Here also y is equal to minus 6. 2 into minus 3 is minus 6 plus 21 upon 5. So you will get, therefore x is equal to 8 minus 3. 8 minus 3 is equal to 5 upon 5. 5 upon 5, 1. X is equal to 1. No place here. I don't have place, so I have written here. Okay? This step you will write below it. So x is equal to 1. And y is equal to minus 6 plus 21 will be 15 upon 5. So therefore, y is equal to 3. So your coordinate of P will be, your P coordinate will be minus, P coordinate will be 1, comma 3. Okay, your P coordinate is 1, comma 3. So you will use section formula by using this x is equal to mx2 plus nx1 upon m plus n. And y is equal to my2 plus ny1 upon m plus n. Before that, you will mention this all. Huh? You have to mention x1, what is x1, what is y1, what is x2, y2, m, m is 2, n is 3. Okay, here the sum gets over. Please copy it down. Okay, now come to question number 2. Question number 2 is also same. You have to use section formula. There are total 3 sums. Okay, related to that. So one sum only I will show you, because it is just like the first one, what how we have solved, and I am showing you the second sum. Now here, point A divides line segment PQ in ratio 2 is to 1. 2 is to 1 means A ratio B is given 2 is to 1. Value of A will be 2, B will be 1. Okay, you have to find the coordinate of A. Coordinate of A, that is x comma y, you have to find out. P coordinate is minus 3 comma 7, Q coordinate is 1 comma minus 4. So here x1 is equal to minus 3, y1 is equal to 7, x2 is equal to 1, y2 is equal to minus 4. And A ratio B, you know, it is given 2 is to 1. By using section formula, this like this you have to write, and your formula will be x is equal to ax2 plus bx1 upon a plus b, ax2 plus bx1 upon a plus b, comma y is equal to ay2 plus b y1 upon a plus b. Instead of mx2 plus nx1, instead of m and n, m and n, in the place of that we are using a and b only, that is the change. Okay, rest of sum is same. So therefore x is equal to a is, a will be 2, 2 into x2, x2 is 1 plus b is 1, and x1 is minus 3 upon 2 plus 1. Here also y is equal to a, a is 2, y2 is minus 4 plus b is 1 and y1 is 7 upon 2 plus 1. So here you will get x is equal to 2 ones are 2, and here 1 into minus 3 will be minus 3. So 2 minus 3 upon 3. And here y is equal to 2 fours are 8, means minus 8 plus 7 upon 3. Okay, so no place here. I am writing it here. So x is equal to 2 minus 3 is minus 1 upon 3 comma. And y is equal to minus 8 plus 7 means minus 1 upon 3. So your a coordinate will be minus 1 upon 3, comma, minus 1 upon 3. So you got the value of a coordinate. Okay, minus 1 upon 3, comma, minus 1 upon 3. So like this, we have two more sums in this. Question number 2, you have two more sums. So very easily, you can solve by using this section formula. It is not at all hard. Very, very easy. Okay, please copy it down. Now come to sum number 3. In sum number 3, also we are using section formula, but in this sum you have to find the ratio m ratio n equal to question mark. We have to find out m ratio n. Here you can see t coordinate is minus 1 comma 6, okay, p coordinate is minus 3 comma 10, and q coordinate is 6 comma minus 8. So I am writing here x is equal to minus 1, y is equal to 6, x1 is equal to minus 3, y1 is equal to 10, x1, y1, x2 is equal to 6, and y2 is equal to minus 8. You have to find out m ratio n. This you have to find out. So by using section formula, okay. Now, there are two, you know, for x also and for y also. But to find out the ratio, there is no need to use both. You need only one. So, only one we are using. That is, x is equal to mx2 plus nx1 upon m plus n. Only one we are using. Okay. With the help of this one, okay, you can get the ratio. There is no need to use second one. Okay, why? Because we need to find the ratio. Now x, x is what? Minus 1, m, m you don't know, x2, x2 is 6 plus n, n you don't know, x1, x1 is minus 3 upon m plus n. Okay, now m plus n will come up here, so you will get, therefore, minus 1 into m plus n is equal to 6m minus 3m. Okay, this will come up. Now you will open the bracket. Bracket you will open. Minus 1 into m will be minus m. Okay, minus 1 into n will be minus n is equal to 6m minus 3m. Just open the bracket. Okay, now take mm one side, nn other side. So minus m minus 6m. Plus will come here, becomes minus. So minus 3n is remaining now. So this minus will go there, becomes plus. So you will get minus 7m minus minus plus, you know. And here it will be minus 2n. Minus 3 plus 1, minus 2n. Minus minus cancel, you will get 7m is equal to 2n, and therefore m upon n will be m upon n. So what will be m upon n? Okay, it will be 2 upon 7. This 7 will come down. Ye iske niche aa gaya, n iske niche aa gaya, 7 will come here. So therefore m ratio n is equal to 2 ratio 7. So very easily we are getting m ratio n, that is 2 is to 7. Please copy it down. Again I am saying there is no need to use both. Okay, only one x. For x, with the help of this x formula, we can get the ratio. Very easily we can get the ratio. Please copy it down. Okay, now come to sum number 4, practice set 5.2. Okay, it is told that P is the center of the circle. Okay, and AB is the diameter. That means P is the midpoint of AB. So here P is the midpoint of AB, correct? So now P coordinate is minus 2, 0. A coordinate is 2, minus 3, and you have to find out D coordinate, that is x2, y2. This is x, y. X is equal to minus 2, y is equal to 0. This is x1, y1. X1 is equal to 2, y1 is equal to minus 3, and x2 is equal to question mark, and y2 is equal to question mark. You have to find out x2, y2. It is very easy sum. You will use midpoint formula by using midpoint formula. Okay, all of you know midpoint formula. Midpoint formula is x is equal to x1 plus x2 upon 2 and y is equal to y1 plus y2 upon 2. Very easy formula it is, midpoint formula. Okay, x, x means minus 2. Minus 2 is equal to x1. X1 is 2. 2 plus x2 upon 2. Okay, y. Y is 0. 0 is equal to y1. Y1 is minus 3 plus y2 upon 2. Okay. So, x is equal to x1 plus x2 upon 2. So, you want the value of x2. So, now this is divided. This will come up. It will be multiplied. So, minus 2 into 2 is equal to 2 plus x2. So, this will be minus 4 is equal to 2 plus x2. Okay. And here 2 into 0. 0 into 2 will be 0 only. Minus 3 plus y2. Okay. So, 0 is equal to minus 3 plus y2. So, here you can see this plus 2 will come here becomes minus and this minus 3 will come here becomes plus. So, no place. So, I am writing it here. So, minus 4 minus 2 is equal to x2. Okay. So, this will be minus 6 is equal to x2. X2 you got minus 6. Right. And for here y2, here y2 minus 3 will come here becomes plus. So, y2 is equal to, okay, 0 plus 3 is equal to y2. That means 3 is equal to y2. Your y2 value is 3. That means your x2, this is x2. Your x2 you got minus 6 and y2 you got 3. So, you got the coordinate of x, b. Coordinate of b is minus 6, 3. Okay, please copy it down. In last you have to write D coordinate is, okay, D coordinate is minus 6, 3. Correct? Very easily you can get the answer. Copy it down. Now come to sum number 5. Here in sum number 5, point P divides line segment AB, okay, in ratio. That ratio is not given. You have to find the ratio as well as the value of K. Okay. So here A coordinate is 8, 9. P coordinate is K, 7. D coordinate is 1, 2. You have to find the ratio also. Now, you know how to find the ratio. As I told you how to find the ratio. So, here here x, this is x, this is y. X is equal to k, y is equal to 7. This is x1, y1. X1 is equal to 8, y1 is equal to 9. X2 is equal to 1 and y2 is equal to 2. You have to find out m ratio n. So for finding out m ratio n, you will use section formula by using section formula. Okay, your section formula you will use. Okay, now for you using the section formula, you will take the help of y. This is x and this is y. X we don't know, so you have to take the help of y. Means y is equal to my2 plus ny1 upon m plus n. You will take the help of y. So now y is how much? Y is 7. M you don't know. Y2 is 2. N you don't know. Y1 is 9 upon m plus n. So this will come up. So 7 into m plus n is equal to 2m plus 9n. Okay, I am writing it here. 7m plus 7n is equal to 2m plus 9n. Okay, 7 into m, 7n. Therefore, mm one side, 7m minus 2m is equal to, what is remaining now? 9n is remaining. This will go there, becomes minus. Okay, you know very well, 7 minus 2 is 5m, 9 minus 7 is 2m. Therefore, m upon n is equal to 2 upon 5. 5 will go there. N will come here, 5 will go there. So, you got m ratio n is 2 is to 5. Now, you got the ratio. Okay. Now, we want the value of k also. We want the value of k also. So, you will use x. You will take the help of x1. Section formula for x. Now, first copy it down. First, we are finding the ratio, then we will find the value of k. Please copy it down. Okay, now to find out the value of k, you will take the help of section formula again. Okay, which one? For x, x is equal to mx2 plus nx1 upon m plus n. Okay, x is what here now? K. So I am writing here k. K is equal to m. M is 2. Okay, m we have to consider 2. X2. X2 is 1. Plus n, n we have to consider 5, okay, and x1, x1 is 8 upon m plus n, 2 plus 5. So very easy, okay. Therefore k is equal to 2 1s are 2 plus 8 5s are 40, 5 is a 40 upon 5 plus 2, 7. So you will get k is equal to 40 plus 2 will be 42 upon 7. 7 1 the 7 6 the, and therefore k is equal to 6. Very easily you are getting the value of k. K is equal to 6. Please copy it down. So okay, first you have to find the ratio. After finding the ratio, then again you will use section formula and you will take the help of x. X coordinate ka help lene ka. X is equal to mx2 plus nx1. Okay. Please copy it down. Okay, so now my dear students, we have completed practice set 5.2 till sum number 5. Now next time we are going to continue this. We will start from sum number 6. Okay, I hope all of you have followed this, you have understood this. So stay home, stay safe, keep watching my video. Thank you very much.